Hello and welcome to our technical analysis session, the Daily Nifty Insight with MJ. Let's study, explore and understand the current stock market scenario with the help of performance of Nifty today. It's the 20th May today and we will be estimating the probable moves, resistance and support levels and the new range emerging in Nifty for the next trading session on 21st May. Today the broader market started with the positive cues from the global market. The market sentiments were further lifted up by a mention from the finance minister that the government is ready to provide more stimulus to support the economy if needed. Pharma stocks rallied almost 4%, led by metal and banking stocks rising 2% each. The market breadth remained very positive today. 42 stocks advanced, 8 declined from the stack of Nifty 50. However, the increasing cases of COVID-19 in India and the extension of lockdown is still a matter of concern in the market. We had expected the market to remain in the range bound and consolidation mode based upon the data and sentiments of the participants available from the previous day. The Nifty consolidated in the range of 8,800 to 9,100 as estimated yesterday. It was good to see the market rallying higher today after many days of consecutive fall. As we had mentioned in our previous Nifty analysis, that the market is already in the oversold zone and you should not get surprised if you get a small bounce back. Now you can see the daily chart of Nifty on my screen. Nifty opened at 8,889 today with a small gain of 10 points and remained sideways for first half of the day. It rose post lunch to the day's high at 9093 and closed at 9066 with a good gain of 187 points. Let's see what kind of current scenario is emerging at present. Trend in Nifty is still sideways and consolidation. You can see that from the Nifty chart. It's a daily Nifty chart, right? Today it made a bullish candle. And it also made a higher low as well as higher high. So that gives an indication that, you know, the trend may reverse if it continues upside. Besides, we are in the lower trend line of the ascending channel. Although there is a head and shoulder already in existence and the neckline has been broken, and neckline has been broken decisively. And today, if you look at the high of Nifty today was also resisted by neckline, apart from the resistance levels, what we had defined, right? So that's a kind of scenario emerging in Nifty. Let's find out the support and resistance levels from price action as well as Fibonacci levels. Now, if the market continues to go up tomorrow with a positive cues from domestic and international market, you would see the first level of resistance coming up at 9092. That's today's high, right? And the second level of resistance will come at the opening price of 18th May. That's 9158. That's going to be the second level of resistance. The third level of resistance market will face at 9213, right? And the fourth level of resistance, if this level is crossed, will be 9281, right? That's the maximum Nifty could move tomorrow from the price action side. And looking at the Nifty's ATR in a current scenario. And if Nifty starts falling further, you would see the first level of support coming at 8990. The second level of support Nifty will get at 8932, right? That's also a Fibonacci number. And the third level of support Nifty will get at today's low, which is 8875, right? And if further this level is broken, you can see that Nifty will get a support at previous day's low, that is at 8856, and the next is at 8807. So the lowest max to max, it can go to 8807, unless until there is something drastic happens in the market. Of course, there is no guarantee of, you know, market just being in the range bound. It's market, and market's uncertainty is like, nobody can predict that. But what we are trying to estimate is from, based upon the price action, what has happened in the past and the existing ATR of Nifty, right? So that's from the daily chart. Now let's see. So from price action perspective, we can see that 8,807 to 9,213 could be the trading range for tomorrow, right? Now let's look at what is happening on the option chain front, right? So this is the option chain expiring on 21st May, that's tomorrow, right? And today market closed at 9066. That means we can consider 9050 as a ATM, right? On the right hand side, you can see the puts. On the left hand side, you can see the call. And we will be observing the built up of open interest, right? What are the new open interest and what are the total open interest existing at any price to estimate the support and resistance level of Nifty, right? So if we look at the near the ATM, that's on the put side, at 9100, you see 2,35,000 new contracts. At 9050 itself, 4,11,000 contract, and 9,000 new contracts are almost 8,41,000. This shows that there is a huge support built up here, right? At 9,000 level, right? And the total open interest is 16,11,000. You go 50 points down at 8,950, you see another 5.22 lakhs contract at 8,900, 6 lakh people. So almost at every level, new contracts have come up, new built up has happened. So these are the very strong support levels existing for Nifty. Downside, if you see at lower levels, a lot of put unwinding has happened. Even at 8,007, a small put unwinding has happened. So we consider only up to 8,800 as a strong support level. So we'll write it, it's a support level. And on the call side, let's find out where are the resistances. But before that, let's see where is the unwinding of call has happened. So the unwinding of call has happened from 8,650 level to 9,000 level. At 9,000 level as well as 8,900 level, if you see the unwinding is huge, that means these participants, or rather these call sellers, are expecting market may not, you know, remain below 9,000 level on the day of expiry, right? So where are the new built up come up? So at 9,150, 1.46 lakhs, 9,250 seems to be a strong resistance level, where almost 2.86 lakh new contracts have been sold. And 9,300, you got 1,18,000 new contracts coming up. And the maximum built up is at 9,200, 16.41 lakh contract. This is also a very good resistance level, 9,100. So 9,100, 9,200, and 9,300 are emerging as a very strong resistance levels. Of course, at 9,400 also, there is a good build up. And on the higher side, 9,500, 9,600, 9,700, at all these levels, unwinding has already happened. That means what? The last traded price is less than now almost 1 rupee. So people have already shifted their money to either next expiry contracts, or at the lower levels where the premium is still more, right? So looking from this option chain for tomorrow, we can see that the trading range could be between 8,800 and 9,300. That's the trading range. And tomorrow is expiry, so market could turn out to be volatile. And still, if you see the overall built up, even at 8,500, there is still 1 lakh contract at 8,600 level, 12 lakh contracts. On other side, at 9,500, there are 13,50,000 contracts are still existing on the call side. So that means there is a huge range of strikes where puts and calls are still existing. That means there could be a volatility there tomorrow in the market, right? And the PCR for Nifty is 0.90. So it has increased from 0.61 of yesterday. That means today the negativity in the market has reduced. However, that still gives you a neutral to negative bias from the perspective of option traders, right? So now looking at the provisional data, it shows that FIIs were the net seller with 1,466 crore rupees. So FIIs consistently have been seller from the March onwards, while as DIIs today were net buyer in cash market with a 2,373 crore rupees buying, right? Also, if you look at Nifty and Bank Nifty index futures, FIIs are still net. Not only FIIs, pros are also net short in the index futures. So in conclusion, we can say that Nifty trading range is emerging as from 8,800 to 9,250 or 9,300 for tomorrow's trading session. However, volatility could be there. And again, it will be part of consolidation before Nifty takes any other move. So we cannot say that the trend has reversed yet or trend is continued unless and until Nifty crosses 9,200 or so on the upper side or 8,800 on the downside. Thank you very much for watching the video. To get more details and technical reports, you may also see our Facebook page where we have published all the reports of FIIs, DIIs, retailers, or, you know, pros. I trust you are getting benefited from our technical analysis. We provide quality information and excellent learning through our videos. To get the latest information, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is by name Project Academy. And don't forget to press the bell icon to get latest notification. To learn more about the stocks, derivatives, commodities, and forex, you can request for videos of your choice or the subject of your choice in the column section comment, right? We would try to make videos as per your preferred subjects. Thank you for watching and liking the video. Please share the video with your friends and family members who can also be benefited from quality knowledge and analysis. Thank you. Happy trading and happy investing.